Okay, so it looks like Twitch has, that doesn't make any sense. Twitch is claiming that I have been live for 22 hours. That's more like it. I'm actually just going to take a quick second and check my VODs to make sure nothing crazy was happening. Good God. Sorry about this, guys. I just want to make sure that I wasn't broadcasting all night. No. No, I was not. Okay, that is good news. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to day three of our special casts. And the one thing I dislike about the game tagging feature of Twitch is that it makes surprises a little bit hard to do. But I'm sure many of you will have noticed that we've got Half-Life on the docket today. This is very different from how I remember playing it. I played it, I think, pretty close to when it first came out. Definitely did not see a picture of Gordon Freeman like this. And I remember once upon a time I was extremely confused by the fact that Half-Life sort of like downloaded and installed itself, because I think I'd lost the key. I had the key, but I think I'd lost the disk or something like that. And that was my first experience either with Steam or what eventually would become Steam. So I think what I'll do here, I'm not sure if I'm going to do medium or hard, but I'm going to start with the training room and we'll figure it all out. Move forward by pressing forward, back.
Hello
Oh,
and
that's
welcome
helpful.
to the Black Mesa Hazard Course, where you will be trained in the use of the Hazardous Environment Suit. I am your holographic assistant. Let's begin by stepping into your suit. You can see it suspended up ahead of you. If you see one of these buttons, press it, and I will appear to demonstrate certain moves.
I'll maybe wait, I just want to jump down the hole. But yeah, so I'll try and save some of the commentary in that for when some bodies are in the the chat. I'll probably, I mean, I'll talk a little bit about it right now. I feel like I should be able to go through something. Oh, there we go.
Moving around in your HEV suit can be slightly disorienting at first. Take a moment to familiarize yourself with basic movement, and soon it will fit you like a second skin. I will see you just around the corner.
Should actually take a quick minute here. I didn't take a look at the graphics options, but I don't think there's a whole lot of yeah. Nothing to see there. I don't think I can speed run it, but at the very least, I'll not dawdle in the training.
The first move we will practice in the hazard course is basic jumping.
Yep, done.
You will attempt to get over this set of pipes using only your run and jump commands. It helps to get a running start. Watch me and then try it yourself. You will now duck under the next set of obstacles. Please note that crouching will automatically shift your suit into stealth mode, minimizing movement noise.
I actually really love the fact that the tutorial in this says, if you would like to crouch, use the crouch. I guess they call it the duck button, but it's like,
Very good. I hardly noticed you. Move on to the next area.
I'm gonna guess that maybe. If it says jump, I'm gonna know that the jump button is what I need to press,
Now
but.
we will combine skills. You will need to jump, duck, and then.
Good work. You look prepared for the next.
To get into these pipes, you will have to signal your suit to make a duck jump. You'll want to stand right at the mouth of the pipe and continue to press forward. Then jump up, and while you're in midair, go into a crouch.
Oh, so it's complicated.
Tricky, but you'll find it comes in handy. Nice job. Walk directly into the ladder, look up, and continue moving forward. If you want to come back down, just move backward.
I can't remember if this was an option you were given at the start, or...
The next three jumps get harder each time, but they are quite possible. Don't be surprised if you miss the last one a time or two. If you can make all three in a
continuous run, Johnny Big Time.
You are doing well.
It is indeed the original Half-Life. I think if I didn't play this when it came out, I played it pretty close to when it came out.
Long jumping requires its own charging module, seen here. To activate your long jump, you will have to duck and move forward, and then launch into a jump. Once you're up on the platform, press the button, and I will demonstrate the move. Power assist movement activated. Nice job.
I also remember playing a lot of Counter-Strike back in the day.
Please start the lift by moving up to the button, looking at it, and pressing the use key.
It was actually Gooseman.
Up here, there's only one way down. Find the target on the floor below and do your best to hit it.
What kind of
If you take any damage from the fall, we will administer medical care at the next station.
No! No! So yeah, Gooseman went to Simon Fraser University, which is the other big university in Vancouver. I went to UBC, but yeah, there's a local connection there.
You will find med kits like this one throughout the Black Mesa compound. To restore your health, walk up to a med kit and press your use key. Your health will recover gradually until you are at full health or the kit is depleted. Once the light goes out, a med kit cannot be reused.
You remember when Counter-Strike was just a mod, not a real game? Yep, I do too. And then, like, I remember seeing a paid version of Counter-Strike, and I was like, that doesn't make any sense. You can just get it for free if you have Half-Life.
Fantastic.
Then I realized that gaming had changed. There's actually a long time. Actually, I should maybe talk about this, because...
Sometimes you'll need to rely on more than just your suit to get through a tight place. Try jumping this gap on your own.
No.
What you really need to do is push that box down into the pit. Pushing is easy. Just move forward against the box and you can push it into it. If you can't push the obstacle out of your way, you might try pulling it. To pull a box, move up to it and press your use key.
There's a period of time where I didn't have I was primarily a Mac user, and I basically got out of gaming altogether. So, oh yeah, absolutely.
Finally,
Johnny.
If nothing else there we go. Works, you can try breaking the objects in your path. Make sure you picked up the crowbar, then simply smash your way through the debris.
Actually, sorry. We need appropriate music for this. Not quite what I need. Sure, that'll work.
Activate Remember, your flashlight drains power, so switch it off when you don't need it. Welcome to the Black Mesa Target Range, where you will receive training in firing a weapon. Please pick up your weapons and head to the firing station. You'll have to hit every target.
That's enough of that. Oh, actually, sorry, Johnny. I didn't see that before.
In order to complete the course. To fire your grenade launcher, use your alternate firearm. Certain targets can break loose and hit by grenades. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, all right, guys. That's it for Half-Life.
Your HEV suit monitors blood oxygen levels, warning you when you need to find an air supply. As you swim through this course, your oxygen levels will begin to drop. At the midpoint, you're given an opportunity to surface for air.
Oh, no.
Catch your air. You will see the blood oxygen indicator on your suit's heads-up display returning to its previous level.
I don't see no oxygen. To teach you about this meter, we're going to try and drown you really quick. Yeah, I was going to say, most of the things are the training simulators.
This is the charging unit for your hazardous environment suit. When you are running low on power, step up to any...
I have the power!
Fire or steel.
Yeah.
Wow. To radiation, activate the Geiger counter and radiation display. Biohazards are also indicated with the luminous icon. Please advance to the next area.
This is just like that puzzle in the beginner's guide. I don't think this training is too long.
Lead a security guard into the next room. He will let you back into the transit system. You must approach a guard and press your use key. He will follow you until you face him and press the use key.
Access denied.
Just killed my way out of here. This is Tell Chalk and Johnny Big Time how great they are. I'd tell Jesse if I saw her in the viewer list. No problem, Joshy Man. I believe Jess might be napping right now. But thank you very much. You have the Beginner's Guide too. Have you played it? I'm probably gonna have to suicide out of this, aren't I? No, oh, I can't suicide out of it.
Lead a security guard into the next room.
Access denied.
Hey, good one, Vladimir Lemon. You are absolutely correct.
Press your use key to engage control.
Hello, Jesse Quill. How are you doing?
completing the Black Mesa Hazard Course. You are now fully certified for use of the HEV Mark IV protective system.
That's cool. I only needed to reset once. All right, because we are hardcore gamers and we appreciate hardcore games for their hardcoreness, we're going to do Half-Life on hard. I feel reasonably confident. But let me take a quick minute and say hello to everybody and thank you. So first of all, we have got Joshy Man, who gave 20 bits to the cast. We've got some wonderful people in here. Johnny Big Time, Jesse Quill, Vladimir Lemon. And I feel like there was one other name in chat, which I missed. Nope, I'm lying. So I didn't do any shout outs yesterday, which is a little bit of a shame because I did have some wonderful support from people. But a couple things out of the way. So I think everybody knows that this has been a charity stream. This is to help a friend of the cast, Eyes of Sin, sort of blunt some of the damage that came from a theft that happened to her. Thank you so much for that, host Jesse Quill. And everybody's everyone's reaction to this has been overwhelming. I did write a blog about what the whole cause was about and why I wanted to do this. And you guys have been remarkably generous in terms of the donations that you've given. I will, as always, encourage you guys, if you haven't donated yet or if you want to put more in, I'm never gonna turn it down. We have been tracking what's been going to Sin's Streamlabs page. I'd love to actually get the code from her to put that on my up on the screen, because I know people really do like to sort of get that recognition. But I am seeing it. I do have something in mind sort of at the end to recognize some the effort that some people have been putting in. On top of that, Johnny Big Time donated something to me personally, and I think I might actually incorporate it into these specials. So I'm really looking forward to doing that. And then there's just been a lot of support sort of behind the scenes. Jess has gone above and beyond in terms of chatting with me about some of the ideas that I have, and has been giving me some great feedback in terms of things that will make the series good, make it entertaining. So a lot of credit goes to her, especially in terms of the games. If you guys have enjoyed the games that have been picked, a very large proportion has come as a result of conversations with Jess, and she also proofread the blog. So as always, I owe Jess a tremendous amount for her support. I am going to get the shout outs out of the way first, because there's a big opening with some exposition. It doesn't have like a lot of dialogue, but I want to get some of the things out of the way. Jesse Quill, always first shout out, always somebody who's hosting the channel, my mod, my only active mod, a wonderful human being, somebody who is very dear and very special to me. Incredibly selfless, both in terms of how she interacts with her own chat and her own community, in terms of how she interacts with other streamers, including streamers who have not necessarily treated her well in the past. And more importantly, somebody who has been remarkably generous to me. It is freezing cold in Ottawa right now, and I don't just owe a wonderful, warm, and rather stylish jacket to her, but I owe the long underwear that I was wearing today, and it made all the difference between me being freezing cold and being taken care of. So Jess's contributions to my life go well beyond casting, which I find a very minor part. Jess is somebody who I can say, you know, I think in terms of the, you know, I think probably the best way I can put this is that there are some things about us that really are, it gets as close to the person as we can imagine. For some of us, it's a game that we played and we just loved. We will always play it. We will always have fond memories of it. For some of us, it could be a song. It could be a book that we read or something like that. And I cannot think of a person who has shared more either formative writings or, you know, TV shows or just concepts which have meant a whole lot to me. And it has been an absolute delight to share them with Jess and see her get as excited by them as I was the first time that I saw them. So, yeah, Jess's influence, both on me as a person, which of course will translate into the kinds of commentary that I give on cast, but also just in terms of my overall quality of life and, you know, making sure that I'm actually willing to do these sorts of things. It's really immeasurable. There's a lot that she's done, which is kind of off the scenes, and it's one of these things where, you know, if it was, it's hard to kind of. Oh, here are some bits to show how amazing she is. Hopefully, you can catch her stream again soon to throw the bits directly at her face. Oh no, you can keep coming here. You can definitely keep sending those bits along. But no, it's, you know, it. Obviously, I really stress the fact that people come and watch streams largely for the person behind them, and I can definitely say from my perspective, you know, Jess has made me a better person. I'd like to think that she has at least, and she has definitely helped me work through some ideas. She's definitely contributed a lot to the stream. Financially, she's contributed a ton. Emotionally, she's contributed even more. And if you want to see all of that, you need only visit her cast. The same compassionate, the same funny, the same talented caster is there ready for the viewing. And more importantly, Jess, Half-Life is a crap game and nobody liked the series. Hashtag super downer. Hello, MC, how you doing? But on top of that, so I'm sorry, if you want to see the person who I'm describing, you really need only see the cast. If you watch carefully, you can see every quality that I just described present there. I'm very, very happy. I'm very proud to be able to call her a friend. And it's actually worth mentioning. When I was playing, GTA 5 yesterday, this is probably the best way for me to handle that. I made what I think people in chat called, and rightly so, a fat shaming joke. And it's really hard. It actually occurred to me that this is a really difficult one for me to navigate because, in one sense, I don't like the fact that nowadays we so like when you think of the when we think of like the Trump advisors, everybody says like Kellyanne Conway is a hideous bitch. Is it Stephen Miller, the guy who got into that row with Jim Acosta over the immigration, is like, oh yeah, he's like bald and ugly, as like Steve Bannon looks like, you know, an alcoholic with a skin disorder or something like that. And the problem is that these are coming from people who normally talk about how bad bullying is, and apparently, as soon as they become a political opponent, it's justified. And I've always been really bothered by that. Not that, you know, I am perfectly capable of making those jokes too. They're funny. I mean, if you want to hear one right now, I'll say that Sarah Huckabee Sanders looks like she's playing Sarah Huckabee Sanders on Saturday Night Live. See, it's a fun game to play. But I've always been uncomfortable with that because I think these are people who you can dispute with on the facts. You know, Steve Bannon is not a bad person because he looks like his liver's about to fail or his skin doesn't look good. There are lots of people with skin conditions who are actually very sweet people and they're very caring. But on the other hand, I've got on my, you know, whenever I do my Crusader Kings 2 streams, part of those streams are entirely about being able to like show what a horrible person I am through the mechanics of the game. And similarly in Grand Theft Auto 5, right? I think nothing about, I mean, I knew Johnny Big Time was in the chat, so of course I wanted to put a bullet through the dog's eyes. You know, when I had a chance to run over Lamar, I took it. And so when I see a bigger guy come out of the car, you know, obviously I'm going to make cardio jokes. But I also sort of know, like, that is a joke on somebody's size. And I can say, you know, I've had to see the streams where people are made fun of for their weight. And I heard a story from somebody on like customer feedback, which was based entirely on their appearance. And I felt really bad for them. And so for a minute there, like for a while, I sort of reflected on that. I was like, well, did I just make like a chat an uncomfortable place? You know, did I just perpetuate a cycle of behavior that I actually think is really negative and things that I don't want people to experience? And Jess talks about these issues quite a bit. So she was the one who, you know, I talked with her about it. I said, I was like, did I do wrong by some people in the cast by stooping down to that cheap joke. Because in some cases, right, like the fat joke is always the low-hanging fruit. She said she thought it was funny, so I guess that's one person who thought that was, I'm trying not to identify, I'm trying to keep people anonymous. But yeah, it was tough, because like Jess knows my tendency in these cases is normally to write full-on apologies to people. And I mean, she has the benefit of knowing who I am in real life and knowing that I'm not like that. Do I think that bullying is protected form of speech under the First Amendment, assuming that Canada has something similar? Our speech freedoms are a lot less limited, a lot more limited than you would think here, Joshy man. Isn't the First Amendment specifically about what I don't actually recall exactly the wording of the First Amendment. Let's take a look and see. I really should get into the game quickly, but I want to shout out Johnny Big Time as well. Let's see the exact wording of the First Amendment. Prevents Congress from making any law respecting an establishment of religion, prohibiting free exercise of religion, or abridging freedom of speech, freedom of the press, and the right to peacefully assemble or to petition governmental readiness of grievances. It was adopted on December 15th, 1791, and is one of the 10 amendments that constitute the Bill of Rights. Yeah, Jesse Quill's, I think Jesse Quill has it there. That seems to be about the government. But I also think there are social mechanisms to make people feel the consequence for careless speech like that. So I don't know, with that in mind, I probably shouldn't have talked about this, but this is the mea culpa. So if I did make somebody feel uncomfortable with that joke, I apologize. Again, I do like focusing a lot on how game mechanics turn you into a horrible person. It didn't sit right with me, and then Jess talked to me about it, and she said it was a good bit, and I shouldn't have to worry about it, but yeah, it was maybe worth addressing. Now, not to be outdone, and we will jump into the game straight after this, I was super happy to see Johnny Big Time. I was super happy to see Johnny Big Time be excited about Half-Life, because Johnny, I don't think I've ever actually said this, but there are two people whose opinion of the cast matter a lot to me. You appreciate me being sensitive enough to realize you might have hurt someone and having enough empathy to apologize and address it. Well, this is the... no, yeah, Johnny Victor. I thought the fat-shaming comment was hilarious. I was like, that is completely what it is. And then I was reflecting on it a little bit, and I was like, you know what? I might have actually just made somebody really uncomfortable doing that. Obviously, you know, I was pulling from some of the examples that I have inside of, you know, my own experience of like modding for people and things like that. But it was maybe, really, that was an opportunity for me to sort of talk about how Jess has become a little bit of a moral compass for me whenever I make the wrong move. So that was maybe supposed to be a little bit less of an apology, but it turned into one anyway. So, but I will mention about Johnny. So there are two people whenever I cast that I really secretly want to get the approval from. I am like really, I shouldn't be saying this, but I've already committed to it. Jesse Quill is obviously one of them. If Jess were to say, I'm very disappointed in you, I would probably just crawl into a corner and die. But another one of the people whose opinion I really value on Twitch, and I think one of the people that when I like really sit down and think about it, and it's like, would I feel like, would it make my night to hear that was a good cast? The other one is Johnny Big Time. If you guys have not seen his cast, he is just an incredible entertainer. He is, I kid you not, one of the people who, I don't know, like, I've never seen him do a bad cast. Whenever he's pissed off or whenever he's been having a bad day, he, like, gets even funnier. Like, he just seems bulletproof when it comes to casting. He is just completely, like, always on point. He is hilarious. He's also very good at the games that he plays. I think this is, like, one of the most criminal features of Twitch and Twitch communities. First of all, our follower counts should be switched. because Johnny is just a phenomenal entertainer. And, you know, one day we are all going to be talking about the fact that we knew him when he was a smaller caster. I mean, now he's a reasonably sized caster. Another fat joke there. No, I'm sorry. That's awful. His cast is, you know, a perfectly respectable size in terms of follows, but he's sorry. I'm just seeing Jess's reaction. I really shouldn't be looking at chat during this. No, like his cast is perfectly fine, but like you guys are actually making me laugh in chat. He's just one of these people, like at some point we're going to be talking about, we knew him when we were all young and like starving casters trying to find an audience. Like he is somebody who, it doesn't matter the game that he's playing. It doesn't matter whether he's had a bad day or not. He always comes in, is always on, is always hilarious. And on top of that, and I don't think he gets enough credit for it, he kills it every time he plays the game. There's a game that Jess and I love playing called Chaos Reborn. And Johnny, like, after this first couple times of playing it, was at a point where, you know, he would sort of contest me and it would be like, oh shit, I really need to work to win this. He's just, again, he seems to have it all. It's absolutely amazing. So like I said, between the two casters, Jess and Johnny big time are people who, their opinion I value very much. Their approval is something that I secretly kind of seek. I've tried to get over the point of like having heroes or fanboyism, but every once in a while, like I said, if one of them were to say, it's like, you know what, you really weren't on top of that. I think I'd die a little on the inside. And they're easily the two people who I need to say, if you're not following them, if you're not watching them, you need to. They are wonderful human beings. They are great entertainers. They are doing original things on Twitch that you cannot get elsewhere. And they are really the only reason why I continue to stream on this platform. There's people like Alex the Rambler who are great, but he's also got a big YouTube channel. I would argue his YouTube channel is probably better than his Twitch channel. That's not a statement on his streaming. That's just a statement on the fact that he's more established on that platform. And I think Total War works a little bit better as like individual VODs. Although I do like his Hearts of Iron stuff. So I think Alex is probably one of these people who can kind of stand astride both both formats and be able to handle them well. There's lots of people whose casts I respect, and there's lots of people who I think are nice on the platform, but like Jess and Johnny are really two of these people where it's like, you know, if they were to stop being on Twitch or if they were to stop coming into the cast, I would probably be reevaluating how often I do the casts. So anyways, I could turn that around on you and say that they were talking about my penis. Wonderful. Yeah, if it's my channel, we're pretty much always talking about the cock. But anyways, on with the game.
Good morning, and welcome to the Black Mesa Transit System. This automated train is provided for the security and convenience of the Black Mesa Research Facility personnel. The time is 8:47 a.m. Current topside temperature is 93 degrees, with an estimated high of 105. The Black Mesa compound is maintained at a pleasant 68 degrees at all times. This train is...
I remember this taking a long time to load between levels.
To Sector C test labs and control facilities. If your intended destination is a high security area beyond Sector C, you will need to return to the central transit hub in Area 9 and board a high security train. If you have not yet submitted your identity to the retinal clearance system, you must report to Black Mesa personnel for processing before you will be permitted into the high security branch of the transit system.
Cuphead's like a children's game. It was pretty easy.
Due to the high toxicity of material routinely handled in the Black Mesa compound, no smoking, eating, or drinking are permitted within the Black Mesa transit system. Please keep your limbs inside the train at all times. Do not attempt to open the doors until the train has come to a complete halt at the station platform. In the event of an emergency, passengers are to remain seated and await further instruction. If it is necessary to exit the train, disabled personnel should be evacuated first. Please stay away from electrified rails and proceed to an emergency station until assistance arrives.
I always thought that this intro was longer than it really is, and now I realize that the computer I was playing it on was struggling to render the game on the high quality.
A reminder that the Black Mesa Hazard Course Decathlon will commence this evening at 1900 hours in the level 3 facility.
He's a real doctor.
The semifinals for high school members will be announced.
I too was a research assistant.
Remember, more lives than your own may depend on your fitness. Do you have a friend or relative who would make a valuable addition to the Black Mesa team? Immediate openings are available in the areas of materials handling and low clearance security. Please contact Black Mesa personnel for further information. If you have an associate with the background in the areas of theoretical physics, biotechnology, or other high-tech disciplines, please contact our civilian recruitment team. The Black Mesa Research Facility is an equal opportunity employer.
Never played the original Far Cry.
Actually,
I haven't played any Far Cry.
Personnel. Regular radiation and biohazard screenings are a requirement of continued employment in the Black Mesa Research Facility. Missing a scheduled urinalysis or radiation checkup is grounds for immediate termination. If you feel you have been exposed to radioactive or other hazardous materials in the course of your duties, contact your radiation safety officer immediately. Work safe. Work smart. Your future depends on it. Now arriving at Sector C test labs and control facilities.
Oh, Jesse Gold just broke Joshy Man's heart.
The automated door. And wait for the security officer to verify your identity.
I'm standing right.
Before exiting the train, be sure to check your area for personal belongings. Thank you, and have a very safe and productive day.
Morning, Mr. Freeman. Looks like you're running late.
Look at those fancy reflections off of his helmet. This game is ahead of its time! I'm running late, and then you saunter on the way to the key console. I see your game here, Barney. Possibly my favorite moment of E3 was Johnny Big Time realizing that there's a dog that brings you guns in Far Cry 5. Also, I completely love the way he took the piss out of Dan from Ubisoft. All right, Chapter 1, Anomalous Materials.
Hey, Mr. Freeman. I had a bunch of messages for you, but we had a system crash about 20 minutes ago, and I'm still trying to find my files. Just one of those days, I guess. They were having some problems down in the test chamber too, but I think that's all straightened out. They told me to make sure you headed down there as soon as you got into your hazard suit.
So one of the things that made Half-Life so original was the fact that so when you think about this, right, you've got Wolfenstein, you've got Doom, you've got
the simulation results are perfectly acceptable, you know.
You've got no shortage. Hey, Kaylee Cakes, how are you doing? Classic FPS shooter time. Have you ever played this game out of curiosity?
Now, where did I leave that shutdown procedure chart?
Environment conditions. High impact reactive armor activated. Atmospheric containment sensors activated. Vital sign.
Let's get some dance emotes in the chat.
I wonder if I should run that.
Hello, Wigmoose.
Right on through, sir. Looks like you're in the barrel today.
Yeah, so the thing that made you can imagine Wolfenstein, Doom, Quake, Dark Forces. Oh god, I feel so patriotic looking at that. You've got all of these games, and you start with a gun.
Message for Captain Black, Command and Communication Center.
You've got. By the way, it's very charming that these are. You know, this game is old enough that there's not. These are not digitally projected. These are not LCD screens that are displaying this. That these are basically like. These are basically like billboards. But yeah, so this was really unique in the sense that this is the first game where you did not start with a gun. And in fact, it's just a day at work. You get a minute to ease into it. You get to sort of experience a day in the life of Gordon Freeman before everything goes crazy. And obviously, we started off this little series of games with BioShock, which obviously has a very similar kind of opening. You don't have a weapon. And in fact, I mean, I'm pretty sure the moment there, go look for a crowbar or something, is a reference to Half-Life.
Hello,
sir. But yeah, it was, I don't know, it's fun. It's really neat to sort of see a game like this. I mean, now we take kind of a story-based introduction to a game for granted. But so far as I can tell, this is the first game that I really was aware of that that sort of introduced you in an environment where, yes, it was a first-person shooter. Yes, it was a game where you killed a whole bunch of things, but there was a story behind it, and by God, you were going to pay attention to it no matter what. As someone who starts every day with a gun in their hands, fighting for their lives, it was a welcome relief to play a game where you just went to work like a normal guy. By the way, guys, before I do some dialogue here, Kaylee Cakes is another wonderful supporter of the cast. I keep saying she's recently got back into casting, but she's actually been at it for a while. She had a really sweet anniversary stream with her masseur. And they were playing golf with friends. Kaylee is probably best known for her DayZ streams. She's about the only streamer who I watch who does DayZ. But she played This War of Mine and really got into it a lot more than I did. I felt bad. There's a couple of things that I think might have made her playthroughs a little bit easier, and she sadly had to face the demise of her survivors and sort of the last cast that she did of it. But she really jumped into that game in a way that I sort of hoped she might, but couldn't have really expected. And she just did a phenomenal job with it. Actually, the War Museum's free tomorrow, so I might try and stop by there and take some photos of the Sarajevo exhibit to share. But Kaylee Cakes is just a tremendous, She's a tremendous caster. She's really open to playing different games, probably more so than I am, actually. And I do know I do a variety of games. An absolute sweetheart. Also, if you follow her Instagram, you get to see all the cakes that she decorates. I believe I was astonished. A 12-year-old wanted a Titanic cake, which surprised me. But again, wonderful caster. Strongly recommend that you check her out. And maybe if you ask her, or maybe bug her enough, she might do Half-Life for you.
Hello, Gordon Freeman.
Gordon, it's good to see you. We just sent the sample down to the test chamber.
We've boosted the anti-mass spectrometer to 105%. Bit of a gamble, but we need the extra resolution.
The administrator is very concerned that we get a conclusive analysis of today's sample. I gather they went to some lengths to get it.
They're waiting for you, Gordon. In the test chamber.
Six?
Is anyone else getting
Shut
hungry?
Up.
It's about to go critical.
What the hell is going on with our equipment?
It wasn't meant to do this in the first place.
I'm afraid we'll be deviating a bit from standard analysis procedures today, Gordon.
No!
Yes, but with good reason. This is a rare opportunity for us. This is the purest sample we've seen yet.
And, potentially, the most unstable.
Now, if you follow standard insertion procedures, everything will be fine.
Aren't we deviating from standard procedure?
Although I will admit that the possibility of a resonance cascade scenario is extremely unlikely.
Gordon doesn't need to hear all this. He's a highly trained professional.
Guys, ties down to the belt buckle. Makes you look like you have a pot belly otherwise.
Yes, you're right.
Bloody scientists.
Gordon, we have complete confidence in you.
Well, go ahead. Let's let him in now.
Testing. Testing. Everything seems to be in order.
All right, Gordon. Your suit should keep you comfortable through all this. The specimen will be delivered to you in a few moments. If you would be so good as to climb up and start the rotors, we can bring the anti-mass spectrometer to 80% and hold it there until
you may, Kaylee Cakes. You also definitely don't need to ask permission. You're a very dear friend of the cast. This blew my mind the first time I thought it. I was like, oh man, the lights are so cool.
Stage two emitters activating now.
Gordon, we cannot predict how long the system can operate at this level, nor how long the reading will take.
I have a feeling the game's probably overwhelming me in terms of the voice, isn't it? I sure hope something doesn't go wrong. That would be disastrous. There are so many games which are focused on shooting nowadays, I actually want to play as an MIT theoretical physicist.
Standard insertion for a non-standard specimen. Go ahead, Gordon. Slot the carrier into the analysis port. Gordon, get away from the shutting down.
You got what you deserved, you sons of bitches! I just wanted a calm day at work! Oh god! Oh yeah, I forgot, these things damage you and- Chapter 2, Unforeseen Consequences. Oh, son of a bitch! Hello, Morky 007. Okay, this dude needs it a lot less than I do. I don't know a whole lot about first aid, but I bet I can help this guy with the one maneuver I know how to do.
Cascade, let alone create one. Gordon, you're alive. Thank God for that hazard suit. I'm afraid to move him and all our phones are out. Please, get to the surface as soon as you can and let someone know we're stranded down here. You'll need me to activate the retinal scanners. I'm sure the rest of the science team will gladly help you.
Come with me if you want to live. Hard mode is unforgiving. Ah, son of a bitch. I don't think I'm gonna live. I thought this thing was supposed to move down and like slice Barney in half, but apparently I'm wrong on that. Bonjour, chat. Ça va? All right, so the crowbar, iconic Half-Life weapon. One of the things that's so funny about this is I think melee weapons before Half-Life tended to be just like a gun that has infinite ammo and like really limited range. It wouldn't interact with the environment that well. But apparently Valve put a lot of effort into the crowbar to just get the interaction with the environment just right. So the sound and kind of the impression that you're smacking off of something. So like if you notice, here's the movement when I don't hit. And then when I hit something, it behaves differently. Apparently they put a lot of effort into getting the interaction of the crowbar down to kind of create the illusion of this world that you would directly interact with. Which I thought was kind of interesting. In case of fire, do not use the elevator. I'll get the next one. Well, thank goodness I have some armor. I'm sure with 6 health, that's gonna get me very far. Deus Vult. Yeah, I've always, I personally have always derived great pleasure in how I'm able to decorate my... I have a son?
Power 30%.
Apparently, Gordon likes to read the 37th Mandala and the Orchid Leader, both by Mark Laidlaw. Isn't Mark Laidlaw one of the, isn't he one of the writers on this game? Oh, very good, Jesse Quill. I wasn't sure if you knew, I wasn't sure if you knew that that was still an option. All right, I'm gonna queue up the next one. So, Jesse Quill, I'm gonna, oh, here's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna do a dance party. Let's say every $10 that somebody donates towards the cause, that person will reserve the right to write in all capitals in chat, dance party. In honor of Jess's sort of contributions in kind, so Kaylee Cake's got one for free. Jess gets one for in kind, but following that, anybody who donates $10 towards Clothing Sins Nakedness, I will put a song. I obviously get veto on like inappropriate stuff, but Jess, whenever you would like, your song suggestion can come up when you type in all capital letters in chat, dance party, and that is how we're gonna do Half-Life Justice. Also, I mean, I wouldn't complain. obviously, this will shred the VOD, but I don't think too many people read the VODs. Okay, at least the guys in the bathroom got out. Well, I mean... So, I don't know if you guys have played Fallen London. This is the game by Fail Better Games before they did Sunless Sea, but there's a story called Searching for Mr. Eaton's Name. And, there's a Twitter account for Mr. Eaton, which says things, you know, a reckoning is not to be postponed indefinitely, and so on and so forth. And one of the lines is just, ah, 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 ah. So, four of the words, A-H, 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 A-H. To which people now commonly respond, staying alive, staying alive. I got the jukes. I studied watching the Juke Master. This is just like that. I'm pretty sure this is modeled off of that scene in Aliens with Ripley and, is it Newt? They mostly come out at night. Mostly. I probably should have shown a little bit more of that. Basically, what he does is he smashes the filing cabinet on the head crab, which is a good move, and then one of these things comes and gets him. The promotional stuff for Half-Life was had a lot more sort of story-based moments inside of it. He's getting jiggy with it. Yeah, I mean, I will say some of the level design on this I really like. I mean, like, so you look at this nowadays, this is kind of, you know, this is surprisingly tame. You know, there's no shadow for the chair in that. But to see a flickering monitor like this and just this really unnatural twitching, you know, even though this game definitely sort of shows its age, I think, you know, little moments like this definitely still have an impact. It's one of the reasons why I do like the idea of coming back to... Nope, sorry, Barney. That's my health. Thanks for dealing with the alien for me. I think this is some of the reasons why I really like coming back to... reasons I like coming back to... oh, Jesus, what is that? So I think if you hit these things enough, they stop charging. Cool. Jess, would you like a new spine? Slightly used. So the trick on these guys I always notice is that if there's two of them and you have to decide which one you want to beat the crap out of, they're going to blow themselves up. Basically, if two of them get the drop on you, you have to pick which one you want to take on. And, you have to pick which one you want to take on, otherwise, both of them fire off and you lose a bunch of health. So out of here, it seems like the majority of chat has played this game before. Are there any people here who have never experienced Half-Life? I know Kaylee and Jess haven't, so two favorite casters. I don't know what just spawned. Hey, Captain Zergy, how you doing? Oh, Jesus Christ, this motherfucker again. You played it, never finished it. Oh, the ending's pretty good, Joshy Man, in my opinion. Definitely rewards the full playthrough. The one thing I will say on difficult, I don't find difficult hard to beat.
Let's go. You're not going to have to leave me here, Gordon.
I don't find hard mode particularly difficult to win. One thing I do find hard though is I have a tendency to be like really cautious and to take my time with the enemies. So I think it. Damn it. So presumably there's a way that I can bring a scientist to get all that cool. Oh, there we go.
The way. Why, just look at those peculiar markings.
Guy probably has like some degree from, I don't know, let's say Cambridge physics or something like that. Probably, ooh, grenade. Just never met.
The containment system has completely failed. Glad to oblige a fellow scientist. I'm slowing you down, am I?
Okay, fine. Let's see how well you handle
you
ladders.
Know I'm here. I'm going to stay here and wait for my colleagues.
Have fun. All right, I think we are set to go down. There's a sneaky head crab that's gonna jump out at me as soon as I jump down. Oh, all right then. So the trick I always found with these things was they would jump out at you, and then there's a small recovery time that they have. So you basically go in and just go to town on them from behind, kind of like my first date. And then you're usually safe. I could use the gun, but that wouldn't be fun. Take your time, Gordon. It's not like there's something hostile. There we go. By the way, if these things actually do hit you, it is horrifying. Oh, I remember this. Jess, if I were to suggest to you that now is a good time for a dance party, would you agree? Or do you want to see what's happening on this and then I can play it? I definitely didn't think this through. God damn it. Oh, fuck me. I'm pretty sure I need to get up there after the, yeah, there's no way of getting up there. Jesus! So the thing that's really fun about that thing, you'll notice it was going after the head crabs, So in this case, it kind of has its own little it has its own little biology inside the game in terms of things. I hope that that was a worthy use of the dance party there. So if you guys do donate to Sin's channel, I don't have an alert set up for that. Obviously, that's a private code for her channel. But I will honor. We do have a way of kind of double checking if somebody's donated. So for every $10, you will get your own dance party. Again, troll songs will be met with troll responses, but I'm going to assume that you're not going to donate to a charitable cause just to annoy me. So, and presumably there's a way for me to get to where that health is. I'm going to assume that I drop some crates inside. I didn't want to have to deal with the acid spitting thing with 4 health at melee range. So you know what, we should be able to make this. So if you get stuck onto one of these things, they start sucking you up. That is generally a bad thing. But yeah, so if you guys do want to do a dance party or something like that, let us know. We'll be able to verify things in Sin's channel, and we'll set you up with some music to make the stream mute. All right, well, now we're full circle. This band should make more music. Yeah, there's another guy too. I really liked what was his name? David Bowie. His last album was pretty good. Anybody know when he's coming out with another one?
No, no.
Oh. Johnny Big Time is not a girl, Joshy Man, but... Or is he the interesting guy? At least two. Hedging your bets there, Joshy. Would all the pretty m'ladies please inform Joshy Man as to their presence in chat so that he may both... Okay, I'm going to save because I'm really bad at jumping puzzles. The trick that I found... So I used to have a lot of problems with the fact that I would fall over the edge, and then it occurred to me that the existence of, like, the hooks were kind of supposed to be the thing that stopped me from flying over the edge. Oh, they're more than at least pretty. I think they're very pretty. By the way, for those of you who would like the Jesse Q Ugg emote, pay up. Is this chapter 3 office complex or tote 2 office complex? The important question, Kaylee, is if it's working.
Oh my god! Where is it?
Ah. So here's a great little example of how the game is teaching you. Please don't go by here. We're gonna put 3 enemies down here and zap them. I'm a little curious if I can try and get into the grate, though. Okay, apparently I can get away with that. Oh, that's right, these are locked. All right. Nuts to that.
Freeman, I see you are in this mess too. A failure of this, Gordon. If I'd known it was you, I'd have let you in. Everyone's heading for the service. But I think they're crazy not to stay put. Someone is bound to come by and rescue us.
For those of you...
I hope those people in the Lambda Lab can get this under control.
For those of you...
What the... ...for this mess.
So for those of you who haven't played it, do you think help is coming? Oh, now that's just horrifying. Run free. Dr. Newell, Scheduled Chaos Theory R&D. Newell, New Well. Electricity hurts. So the question is, can I get over the electrified water for less than 30 damage? Sure, you only YOLO once. Ah! I wonder if I'm not allowed to open that door because of the water and the fact that they couldn't make it spill all over. I don't know about you guys, but I think they should have made this using the Frostbite engine. I still find it remarkably satisfying to break crates in this game. I'm gonna head back. Crab ass. It's the worst ass. Yeah, you dumb bastards. So those are the crates. I guess I'll go here. Using pistol rounds on these a little bit more, just because I have some, energy, some shields. So if I can, I'd like to avoid unnecessary damage to the armor. For those of you who know Jess and know that she is sometimes a little reluctant to take credit for good things that she's doing, I really love the fact that she is extremely proud of her muscles, which are very impressive, by the way. I've had the pleasure of seeing them in person. God damn it! But it's actually nice to see her take a bow for something that she's done. She is exactly like a strong Nord woman. Oh, those sons of bitches. I used to know exactly every trap that would come into this game, but not anymore. Sure.
I got another one.
I better get more than 3 shotgun shells for this.
Ooh, something died down here. Okay, why not? Didn't want to die alone anyway.
I don't like that kind of pessimism from you, Barney. Yeah, dementia's setting in, Joshy man. We don't have another dance party coming up, do we? Bring it, nerd. Where'd you come from? Thought you couldn't handle stairs. Sorry guys, just one quick second. Picked a great time to stop in absolute silence. I had to destroy a bunch of boxes. I did that there. Oh, okay, so I guess I have to go up to face the turret of death. Okay, so there's a crate immediately down, or maybe I actually head up to the metal one. Just like in NOM! There should be a way that I can jump up on these crates to get to the health. Although it could be that that gets destroyed. Oh, hang on. There we go. What, really? Come on. I should be able to grab things in midair. That makes total sense. Surely there's a small box somewhere here where I can... Aha! I mean, I only have lost 4 health. It's more my armor that's gone, so. So cold in your house. Butter that you left on the counter over last night is still rock hard. Like Jesse Quill muscles. Jesse Quill's muscles make me feel very ashamed at the state of my body. I'm very, very skinny. And I have... whatever I have, it's the opposite of muscles. I think the people of Ethiopia may possibly have done a rock concert to make sure that I get enough food and nourishment. You know what, screw this. Jesse Quill, in reply to your message, all I can say is mostly. Attaboy, Barney. Oh,
okay, we might live longer if we work together.
I gave you moral support there. Ah! Was that friendly fire?
That's one less horror.
What's killing me?
Man, you see that shot?
Stop that! Guy was more of a detriment than a benefit. Probably don't need to use the shotgun on that thing, but... I will give you a small tip, Joshy man. Streamers usually like having a lot of fun with... usually like having a lot of fun with stuff that happens inside the game. But if the majority of stuff that you say in a chat every time you visit is usually reflecting on the bad stuff that a streamer does or the times that they mess up, people will tend to think that you are generally unfriendly to the caster. There's any more health. You can take that however you want, Joshy man. Usually if somebody says something like that, they're not talking about an isolated incident.
What if the world finds out what we were doing down here?
He got hit by the... Wait, that doesn't make any sense. What killed him? Not even gonna ask. One of the things that I really like about the design of Half-Life is actually something that I think I'd forgotten about or didn't appreciate the first time I played it. Is
the secure access transmission. Soldiers have arrived and they're coming to rescue us. Of course, I have my doubts that we'll live long enough to greet them.
So one of the things that I really like is that there's a... I think they have a very good understanding of when you feel safe. So normally it's like, okay, I see an enemy in front of me. I'm going to, you know, fire and kill it, and then it's done. And then in hard mode, I tend to notice what they do is there's always a follow-up. So if you open a crate, there's a headcrab behind it. When you're heading towards an exit, there's a headcrab in the opposite direction. Crap. There's not an obvious way for me to deal with that, so I think I'm just gonna leg it. Oh, yeah. That's a perfect example of that. I don't think it's worth it to go to the health kit. Basically... Oh, for fuck's sake. So obviously you don't want to get hit by this thing. Actually, you know what?
I suspected this could happen, but the administrator just would not listen.
But yeah, so basically, you think about the design of this, right? Very simple, right? So everybody, you know, you've been trained in this game now to know that when you hear that sort of whirring sound and that beeping, that there's a turret that's going to come and get you. So can you see the ground here? No, you can't. So you're like, okay, well, I'm just going to run up, can still see me from here, so I'm going to go here. Oh my god, there's headcrabs. And the game's filled with stuff like that. It's something that every time I play Half-Life, I always get to appreciate some of the... I get to appreciate some of the choices like that. Oh, fuck.
Hey, Gordon. Hey, what the hell are you doing down here? Get topside! I hear troops are coming in to save us.
Which guy responsible for what mess?
Run like hell.
Please let me in there. Please. All right. Presumably, oh look, it's Roy Moore. Good to see that he's still getting work. That is not the way to get into that room, it turns out. Well, actually, there could be something behind those doors, or behind those boards. Ah, crap. There's probably going to be nothing behind that. Damn it! What was I thinking? Crap. Hello, Isosin. How are you doing? Have you played Half-Life? As it turns out, this is a first for a couple of friends of the stream. I think I'm going a little too far. So usually, one thing that I tended to learn about this game is if you went down a hallway, and it wasn't a long hallway, there was like a sudden turn, you'd usually get faced with a loading screen. That would mean that you were sort of transitioning between levels. So I don't think I've ever found out how to get into this thing. I would assume that there's some way of getting there, like from the roof, but thanks for your help, Barney. Oh. Probably here. You've not played it. All the m'ladies are being introduced to Half-Life for the first time. All right, if this thing kills me for going on it, I'm going to be very upset. Hello, Sparks5. How are you doing? Also, in case you guys are unfamiliar with the other game series people are referring to, The Cake is a Lie is a reference to another very famous first-person series known as Fear. There was a second one. I have no idea where I am right now. Ah, they got me again. As another perfect example of that, right? Two come out, you're like, okay, it's gonna be safe to walk by now. Don't even look at the other side. And yet it's obviously it's Half-Life Episode 2 that The Cake is a Lie is from. Just wanted to see if you guys would correct me. All right. So I think we lost more than 30 health to get to the 30 health, but at least we're up some ammo. All right, so for those of you unfamiliar with her, it's probably not a bad time for me to be a complete sellout again. We have got the lovely Miss Eyes of Sin in the channel. Eyes of Sin is an occasional streamer on Twitch, but one of the reasons why we are doing what we're doing today is, and for the next 2 weeks as a matter of fact, she was met with some misfortune. Sacre bleu. You be you, Barney. You be you. But yeah, she's definitely a really wonderful friend of the cast. She does a variety of casts. One thing that I quite like about her casts is they're similar to what mine were when I started off, where she has a bit of an older computer, and so as a result tends to play some more classic games or tends to play things that her computer's able to run. It reminds me of when I was broadcasting at 512K. Yeah, it definitely is Noobasaur. I'm just being a silly goose. Incidentally, Jess, as far as the game to voice volume, I'm sometimes worried that the gunshots are too loud. Is it working for you? Jess is kind of my go-to in terms of stream quality stuff, because she tends to know what to look for. She does a nice cast, but she's definitely been somebody who's become more involved with the with my broadcasts. I originally met her because I was helping out, Jesse Quill with her, a charity broadcast, and Eyes of Sin wound up being a moderator there. And I think what Eyes of Sin came to life was actually the rapport between Jess and I, rather than any inherent qualities myself. But Sin has been very generous with her time and has split it evenly between Jesse Quill and Mai's casts. As a result, I've definitely felt a lot better about my broadcast. She has extremely nice things to say about the both of us. And as it happens, when this little bit of misfortune happened for her, I thought a wonderful way to sort of pay back the kindness that she's shown and the just generally the, you know, to try and remind people of the community elements of broadcasting. I thought it would be really wonderful if we could sort of get together and say, it's like, we can't replace everything that was lost. But there's also no reason why you should have to bear the full brunt of this. And so what we're basically doing is a little bit of a fundraiser. It's largely contribute what you can, whatever is an amount that you would not be too upset losing. The idea is that in the aggregate, you know, the individual impacts to us are quite minor, but the... Yeehaw. The individual impacts to us are quite minor, but as a whole, in the aggregate, it winds up being something meaningful, and it maybe takes a little bit of the sting out of the misfortune that happened. And so I will say, it's just the third day of this that we're going on, but I've been absolutely stunned by the levels that people have contributed at. I'm not sure what a normal expectation is. I'm assuming if I save this guy, there's gonna be something I get. I say, I don't know what a normal expectation is for a fundraiser like this. I mean, again, in my own case, I don't particularly know Sin that well. I've definitely come to be very, very happy to see her in chat, just as I am happy to see a lot of you. And I think the thing that really impressed me the most was the fact that people were willing to say, it's like, you know what, it's like, yeah, I may not have a lot, but here's something that I can contribute, and I know that they're going to be part of a larger effort, and that's going to be what makes it, what makes it worthwhile. Eyes of Sin is very fond of saying that there may be better causes, and I'm not necessarily going to disagree, save for the fact that I think there's almost certainly going to be a headcrab waiting for me over this. Yep. I don't want to waste a grenade on it, but... the only thing I would say is that I think the way that we treat individuals matters quite a bit. And so I think building a community in which we care about each other and we say that, you know, rather than making one person suffer all the losses at once, we sort of even them out and basically make things a little blunted, kind of like an insurance policy. And again, whether or not you think Sin individually is worth it, and I certainly do, I wouldn't be doing 2 weeks of casts if I thought any different. I don't think the bullets are worth that. If there's a more certain way for me to... Oh, crap! Yeah, that was definitely not worth it. There's really no reason to take that damage. I definitely had the ammo to spare on that, so instead I've lost the more precious resource, which is health. But yeah, I don't know. I'm of the opinion that the kinds of communities that we build and the reaction that we have to need from sort of our fellow humans is just as important as, you know, some of the maybe bigger macro kind of donations. So, that was obviously less about Eyes of Sin's cast. I can maybe mention that.
Hey, don't count on the cavalry finding us down here. Head for the surface. Elevators are out of order, but we can still climb. See you later. Okay, I'll cover you.
I can definitely say that Isaacson is quite a talented artist. And so I've always really enjoyed kind of looking at her images. I've also really enjoyed some of her descriptions. She has an extremely kind description of my voice, for instance. Go get him, Barty. You are definitely going to want to turn around, my friend. So if you guys do like those kinds of, if you do like those kinds of streams, whether they're creative streams or whether you just simply want to see...
Freeman, who would have thought you'd still be alive?
This is probably the place where we came from, isn't it? Yep. Or if you just want to see somebody playing some more, down to earth or maybe simpler games like Cook Serve Delicious and... Forden Geeman, my arch nemesis. I definitely recommend checking her out for that.
Hello there.
Hello. See, when Barney says he has my back, I now know what that means. Bring it, nerd. Huh. So am I supposed to... Ah. That was much needed health. Surely I can open it. Nope. I always wondered if this is a reference to The Graduate up here. All right. Alley-oop. Oh, hang on, my friend.
I can't hold on much longer.
There's definitely a grip mechanic in this game. I'll be able to save you if you just hang on a little longer. You know what? That's on you, my friend. Or possibly the level designers. Maybe he should have waited until Half-Life 2 had the gravity gun, and then I could have saved him. We've got hostiles.
For God's sake, open the silo door! They're coming for us! It's our only way out! Oh my God, we're doomed!
Hello, Seth. Thank you very much for that host. How are you doing? I don't believe I have seen you before. Are you hosting because of the Half-Life stream? Well, Jesus. I don't think there's any way to get around these. Oh, yep. I'm boned. Half-Life host, thank you very much for that, Hello Seth. I will say I'm not normally a Half-Life streamer. This is just a special event that we're doing. So for those of you looking for elite Half-Life gameplay, this is just a vanilla playthrough for one day for... we're basically doing about 2 weeks of what I'd consider to be the crowd-pleaser games. We are playing on hard, so I'm sure there'll be even more opportunities for me to screw it up. But, I mean, as long as you guys are willing to watch some very vanilla Half-Life gameplay, I am very happy to have you on. Thank you very much. That was definitely a very healthy host. Do you normally play Half-Life? Because I'm sure anybody here who is looking for more regular Half-Life content would be happy to check out your stuff.
Thank you.
probably supposed to use this to jump over the claim. Yee. So I was making noise over that. Ah! Where's the second one? The announcer just said that the announcement system was under military control. You are a bad speedrunner who restarts every attempt 3 minutes in. VOD will back you up. Yeah, I definitely don't speedrun. I am the opposite of speedrunning. As you can see, I don't cast with a camera. I tend to play a lot of games like Crusader Kings, where there will be about 5 minutes of gameplay for every 100 minutes of conversation. Now, there's no reason to think this thing will activate unless I... Oh, you son of a bitch. I have to imagine that's another one that's by design, where they say, okay, so they're gonna think, haha, game, please. And then they drop one of the boarding guns. Probably my favorite thing about Half-Life is always how they are so good at pulling the rug out from under you. My grenade game definitely... Oh shit, there's a door closing. That will not accomplish anything. Yeah, well, so much for the fire door. Like that movie Entrapment. Why? Alright, water is actually kind of a sneaky thing to do on this. Me down there other than death? I'm gonna guess no. Gently. Gently.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I'm thinking, please don't trigger those claymore mines. The Ford and G Man again.
It can't get any worse than this.
It is about to get much worse than this. Alright. Ah, no. Close the damn door! Alright, so much for that. Oh, wow, that really brought me far back. Alright, surely there is a way that I can do this without triggering another wire. Too.
Did you understand that last announcement?
Don't be ridiculous.
Theoretically.
Feels like there's something. I think this is really my only option. Sorry, comrade.
Thank God you're
no, no, you're supposed to kill the guy. That's the story moment. Nope. Oh my God, I can't aim. So, I haven't been talking a whole lot. The big story beat on that is the guy's supposed to say, oh, the military's here to save us, and then he shoots him down, and you're like, oh no, this is horrible. But instead, because it's hard, the game decided to go after me first. I tend to find the shotguns a little more effective against the military guys. Alright, the music means it's now serious. It's not gonna do anything. Can't aim with a shotgun anymore. So one of the really nice things about this game, fuck. They'll use grenades to flush you out, which is wonderful of the AI, but definitely makes for some fairly hair-raising experiences when you're on low health. So the idea on this, Kaylee Cakes, you play a scientist at a base, and it's obviously some kind of government research system. You've got a PhD in theoretical physics from MIT, and basically the build-up is that the soldiers are going to be here to save you. And there's a big reveal in the game. So the way it was supposed to work, and the AI decided to attack me first, probably because it's on hard, but there's basically a scientist that runs down the stairs and says, the soldiers are here for us. And the soldiers gun him down. This is another scene like that where one of the soldiers comes up and they shoot you. So the idea here is that the military has arrived, but they are not here to evacuate the scientists. They're there to clean up the mess. And that means also removing any witnesses. Which is it was a nice little plot twist, in my opinion. But basically, in this game, you have to fight both the aliens as well as the military. I also think there's a hint as to everything not being okay with the military, if you consider the fact that there's claymore mines placed before the first scene where a scientist gets shot down. So I think the claymore mines are supposed to be an indication. I mean, the question that comes out of that is, oh shit, I can hear one. I think the question that immediately follows from that is, well, who put the claymore mines, right? That's not exactly an alien technology. I don't think there is any sensible way for me to get past these beams on my own. Yeah, in this case, Kaylee, it's a pretty clear... Yeah, there's definitely gonna be some... Oh, shit! I think it's pretty clear in the game that they know exactly what they're doing, and it's not that they think everyone's infected, it's just that they're clearly there to cover up. Wait, so I'm just not able to go through here anyway? Ah. Alright. I don't think we have any dance party music, but... I will, because we're going to be doing running on a treadmill. What was it? I say the game's also pretty good at kind of intuiting where you're gonna want some extra health. So like here, I'm kind of close to the edge, but they kind of gave me a little bit of a boost with the health. I have half a mind to blow these things up right now. Oh, yep. I could try and be clever and use it on him, but... things does he have? Oh, he got caught. Sometimes the barnacles wind up helping you. Toss a grenade up there if I have to. Grenades anymore? I realize as soon as I get really into the game, my commentary's been dropping down. I think this is the one problem with doing crowd pleasers. Sorry about that if you guys were looking for more. Jess, I'm gonna guess we haven't had a donation tonight yet, have we? Sorry, I know I'm making you work when you should be enjoying the cast. Two grenades, they really want me. Thank you, Kaylee. Had one from Joshy. Thank you very much, Joshy. Now, did he donate $10 because I owe him a dance party? I don't have to do a dance party then. One thing that I thought was really funny, I think it might have been a Valve employee that did this. I don't think I'm gonna survive this. I haven't taken down a single one of these guys yet. Oh yeah, I was actually meaning to ask Isofson if you would like to have if you'd like me to put the donations up on the screen, I can definitely put like the code up to have a second donation menu come up. I think I'm gonna get hit by that. Nope, we're good. But yeah, so I think somebody was saying that it's like everybody's talking about how the AI for this game is so good, but like I've played it and they just stand there and take all the bullets. And I can't remember if it was a Valve employee or somebody else, but basically it was this really entitled reviewer who was busy just complaining about the game, and they said if you play it on anything other than easy, they will set traps for you. This is not a bad example of it, because you'll notice they're fairly liberally using the grenades to flush me out. Normally what will happen is if you're in a hallway, they'll have two groups that kind of come after you. And as you can notice, like, they really do try to force a one-on-one confrontation with them, because they soak up a lot of bullets and I can't take a lot of bullets. So even if it means one of them heads down, they'll usually adopt a strategy that tries to flush me out and force me to take an engagement that's unfavorable. This is not to suggest the AI for this game is perfect. I mean, again, it's an older game, right? So it's not perfect, but it's definitely it makes an effort to make you pay. And of course, after a big fight, they give you It's like one of the things I'll say, like, obviously the first time I played this game, the reaction, oh, I think there's a big fight coming up. Might be a different elevator now that I think of it. No, I think this is the big fight. Kingdom for a grenade. I got 30 more health I can throw at that. Damn it. I always found this a hard fight. Please use the shotgun! Okay. Yeah, I think the trick on this one that I always screw up is if I stay in this area, then that's basically a death sentence. But if I move around, especially with the shotgun, I'm usually able to get the drop on people. That was a grenade. Tricky. Incidentally, Kaylee Cakes, you were talking about the soldiers a little bit earlier. There is an expansion pack for this called Opposing Force. And the premise behind that one was actually that you play one of the soldiers assigned to Black Mesa. So you play one of these guys. The refresh on the shotgun is so slow. Anyways, we miraculously managed to get out of that with 100 health, so I think I'm gonna save for a really quick second. Okay, sounds good, Isaacson. Sorry, I'm obviously a little preoccupied with a tough fight. Oh, go to hell. I'm gonna get the health and I'm gonna run straight to the... Oh god. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get by with full health. Made it. All right. Let's take a quick look. Thank you very much for that, Sin. So hopefully what will happen here... I have no idea what's going to happen when this goes on, but hopefully when somebody donates to the Eyes of Sin, we will see a... We'll see a message that comes up. Sounds like Joshy Man just did another donation. But... Oh, it's all good, Sin. We'll figure it out. I mean, if it doesn't turn out, it's not the end of the world. It's more just I know people tend to like to see their name appear on the screen when stuff like that comes up. It's just an opportunity to give people a little bit of a reward for doing the donation. Oh, fuck. I need to get a little bit better at measuring this, so it's three single shotgun blasts to take out, Is that a guy beside me? Yep, that was a guy beside me. So sue me. Damn it! Fair enough. Deal with military dudes this time? Works for me. Ah! Get for being cheesy. Surely the game won't be so cruel as to make me fight these things. Let's try and hustle on this, so... Ah, fuck. Yeah, I'm a simp duck as soon as I get on this. Okay, I'm not sure I really want to survive that, well, no worries there, I must have missed something. Joshiman, thank you very much for confirming that the send donation button worked. Crap. I'm gonna wait for that thing to come at me. Not worth it. Okay, now I'm a little curious. Head down like this. So I hear one of these guys who I am definitely not equipped for a fight with.
Well, so much for the government. Their idea of containment is to kill everyone associated with the project. Judging from your hazard suit, I'd say you were part of what went wrong. Isn't that right? Now look, if anyone can end this catastrophe, it's the science team in the Lambda complex at the opposite end of the base. With the transit system out, I couldn't tell you how to get there. But there's an old decommissioned rail system somewhere through here, beyond the silo complex. If you can make it through the rocket test labs, you might be able to worm your way through the old tunnels to track down whatever's left of the Lambda team. You can trust them. You can trust all of us. Good luck.
Alright, so I'm not quite sure what I was supposed to do with those other areas, but I can't get back up, so I will live with that decision. Last pick. More satisfying wood breaking. Alright, that's not a healthy noise. Damn it! I really didn't need that. Took more damage falling over the edge than from the headcrab. Oh, hey! That overhead one that they do like that is a really hard one to dodge. So far I've only got caught by it once on this playthrough, but it's it is one that makes me sad. Alright, so this time we mine the gap. These guys. Well, you know what? Sometimes charging ahead is the way, right way to go.
Let me out!
That's a fun little moment, but I really don't know how you're supposed to get past that without taking quite a bit of damage. Hello, Ricky Guitarist. This is probably your favorite first-person FPS. It's definitely a really good game. I think as the action has gotten a bit more intense, I've been shirking in my duties to give commentary, but I've definitely been appreciating the way the game sort of guides your attention throughout the experience. And I don't know, I definitely like the way that they set up little traps for you based on sort of your expectations. So, you know, you'll kill something, it's like, okay, now I'm safe, and then all of a sudden something teleports behind you. It's like, okay, I've jumped over that wire, so now I don't need to worry about anything. And then, you know, Vortigaunt kind of comes out behind you. Even here, right? Like, as soon as I jumped out, there was acid being spit at me. That bastard. Alright. You. Ha ha! Fuck you! Let's try that again. So out of everything, so you say it's your favorite FPS. Obviously, there's a lot of games that fall into that genre, Ricky Guitarist. So what made this number one for you? What does it have that games that have kind of come after it? What's missing from these modern takes? I don't think I have a source, but I mean, the only Half-Life I've ever played was the original one, so I don't... Ah! Why? I haven't felt too bad. Yeah, I don't even know. I don't know why I thought I could make that. I'm pretty content playing just the original. It's kind of spooky, and you liked the gameplay. Oh, Fear, you mean? I think I really like listening to Soren Johnson's Designer Notes podcasts. And I'm pretty sure the guy who was a designer on Fear, I can't believe I'm getting away with this. Pretty sure a guy who was a designer on Fear described one of the ways he got that job was because he, I think it was the Lithtech engine that used it. So as it was, he had experience with the level design tools that very few other people sort of had the experience with. All right, this is going to get interesting. I made it. So as a result, he got a job making levels for Fear, purely because, I mean, again, he wound up being a perfectly good designer, but he wound up with sort of his break in the industry because he really liked, I think it was like No One Lives Forever or Blood 2 or something like that. And so he was familiar with the tools that the company was using to make make Fear, which I thought was a really interesting story. Doesn't sound up to some FPS games today, but back in the late 90s, early 2000s, nothing touched Half-Life's world-building and environmental storytelling. Being a PC player, that wasn't done much or well at all in the FPS genre. Yeah, we talked about how this, I think, at least in my experience, is the first game where you didn't start off with a weapon. You actually started off with a day at work. Hello. I don't have a lot of ammo left for that thing. Oh, I didn't realize ammo was shared between the pistol and the, I am definitely hurting on ammo now. Gonna have to use a shotgun more often, I think. I have finished the game before. So Ricky Guitarist, we are doing, I'm doing basically a series of crowd pleasers is the best I can describe it. So Eyes of Sin was the victim of a theft, and sort of my view, god damn it, I can never tell which ones are alive. So basically what I thought I would do, I thought kind of, I had been mugged before. And one of the things that kind of happened as a result was a whole bunch of people kind of all independently, sort of without knowledge of each other. Oh, I love this this encounter. This is a really well done.
Fire the rocket engine. Destroy the damn thing before it grows any larger. Snap!
I'm going to take the volume down just a little bit because I feel like I'm getting drowned out a bit by the game. But yeah, so anyways, basically what happened with... Actually, I can, if you want the full explanation, it's in the blog post. But basically, what I found was people sort of all independent of themselves kind of came in and gave these small donations. And... And what kind of happened out of it, it didn't make me whole, but there were two things. One, sort of knowing that people cared enough to give a small amount really felt good. And then the second one was, you can sort of see this as sort of the aggregate of people. Everybody gives a small, almost trivial amount, but because there's a big group of people doing it, you know, it's a more or less trivial expense to them, but what it meant is you lessen the impact to the individual. So I thought what I would do is I would encourage people to try and donate any amount that they could, you know, whether it was $1, $5. The funny thing is that some people have donated 20 and said, it's like, oh, you know, I'm sorry, I just don't have that much money right now. And it's, you know, among some of the highest amounts. But what's really great about it is that, you know, it's just an example of kind of trying to get a community together to say, you know, this could have happened to anyone, any one of us. And, you know, individually it's a negligible expense, but collectively it's something that winds up helping. And so sort of the reason, the way I kind of motivated everybody to try and do a little bit was basically I was going to do 2 weeks, five casting days, so Monday through Friday, of sort of crowd pleaser games. So we started with BioShock. Yesterday was Grand Theft Auto 5. Today was Half-Life. And then basically Thursday and Friday are going to be a couple more surprise games. I might actually change up the lineup a little bit. And then Monday through Friday next week, we'll finish it off. I'm also going to be unlocking some special things that I'll do personally for some people who donate a certain level. But I'm going to unlock those. Although if you donate today or any of the other days, I retroactively count whatever you put forward. So if somebody put, you know, $5 towards it, and then I said, you know, for $35, I'm going to do something for you. If they donate another 30, then they're going to be able to do it, because I don't want to create an incentive to donate late. So.
Yeah. Be quiet. This thing hears us.
You go on without me.
Hey! Hey, over here! Eat lead, you outer space octopus!
So the fun thing about this was that basically, so if you make noise, it starts pounding at your last location. So I'm going to give you an example. Right? So what I'm going to be able to do here is sneak down to the lower level. And now it's just sort of testing to try and find where I am. So to be efficient in your use of grenades, what you can do is when you need to make it to another level, you toss a grenade where you want to open something up. Obviously, you can't use your crowbar, otherwise that thing's going to eat you. Didn't quite get what I needed out of that, so I'm going to toss another one. Toss another one down below just to clear that out. So what you do with the slight typo. Yeah, exactly, Joshy Man. So obviously if I run, then it's gonna, you know, it's gonna know, it's gonna like hit after me. But what I wanted to do first was sort of clear out all the pipes. Jesus. And clear out all the I don't think it has a any cooldown would just be a default for it would just be whatever's built into Nightbot. But yeah, basically it's my WordPress article is there if you want to know the exact reasoning behind it. If you want to donate, it's https://theeyesofsin92. I think we've set it up so that you get a notification now if you donate, which I was happy to get working. But yeah, the idea here is that, you know, Sin is really good at saying it's like, oh, you know, there's other things that you can donate to, and that, you know, that's technically true. But my view is that, you know, I don't want to live in a world in which people are sort of indifferent to what happens to others. If we live in a world, oh damn it, if we live in sort of a community or a culture in which people are willing to sort of help each other out. Sort of recognizing that they could have been in the bad position themselves, then I think we're just generally better off. And sort of as a result, I thought, well, once I heard what happened to her, I knew I was going to do a series of casts. The real question was just how would I structure them and how would I organize them? So, as always, for you guys, if it is within your means, obviously I don't want people who are not in a position to be able to help out, but damn it, that's why I saved. Obviously, if you're not in a position to help out, I don't want to create a hardship. I basically just want to create an inconvenience for people, which is spread out over lots of people rather than just one. If you are in a position to help, I definitely love it if you would consider doing so, because Sin is definitely a very valued member of the community. And I just think in general, it's one of these things where, like, even if you don't feel like you're a generous person offhand, if you fake it long enough, one day you wake up and you become a generous person. So, okay then. And more importantly too, I mean, obviously I'm flogging the donation thing as much as I can. But I do need to say, you guys have gone above and beyond what my expectations for the first 2 days was, so thank you again for that. And I know Sin is very appreciative, and Jess is definitely very happy with, how this turned out. I think she said she was proud of me. And really, what this is all about is making sure the m'ladies think I'm a good guy. Exactly, Kaylee Cakes. Ten brownie points to Gryffindor. That's how that works, right? I'm pretty sure there's always grenades on each one of these levels to make sure that you don't get caught without the without a means of getting past the tentacles. I hate that attack. Okay. Lesson is, I can't... Oh wow, that's making me go back really far. Today I learned you're not supposed to walk by a fan that's going at high speed. Well, crap. I'm trying to think what the purpose of making you, so I'm not quite sure why this is on a higher level. Like, it's not exactly like it's the most tedious, it's not exactly the most challenging puzzle in the world, but it definitely does annoy you when you fall over the edge. Maybe there's like something waiting for you in the water or something, but. Well, this ombre is always here. Okay, I'm gonna save here to save us the trouble of the ensuing madness. I probably should have saved after I dispatched these villains, but... I would have been much more satisfied if that thing got crushed by the door. Okay, I'm not 100% sure how I'm supposed to get past that fan, but I'm gonna guess that stopping and smelling the roses before I go back up the ladder is probably one of the better choices I can make. Nope, I think I just hosed myself. So I guess what I need to do is I hit the button and then I like run. God damn it. Okay. I don't remember it being this difficult. I'm just gonna save and we'll get it right. There we go. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Where are you? I am gonna hurt you so bad. I told myself I wouldn't use bullets, so I won't. I'm actually okay for health right now, so a little bit of damage on a head crab is not the end of the world. Bring it, nerd. Do a quick save here because I have no idea what's waiting for me on the other side. Just use my least favorite attack. Jesus. All right, we only have one more component, then we'll be able to go up and cook the hentai thing. Scarier than a mug? I'm not sure I know what you mean by mug. God damn it! How did that not kill it? Again, I don't exactly have a lot of ammo to spare on that, but... That's more a sanity investment more than anything. Alright, this thing's pissed off again. Pounding more than a weekend when Jess is over. She's not here, right? Okay, I'm gonna be a little sneaky on this one and toss a grenade up on the level I'm currently on. That's basically to just distract its attention. Oh, well, that makes things interesting. Allie? I'm assuming that broken area is to trap players like me who kind of run all over the place with these fights. These things are probably scariest in a claustrophobic environment, so when they take the bridge out behind you, you're forced to either use a shotgun or you sort of suffer the consequences. Now, I'm almost certain there's going to be some monster here that destroys these. Nope, I'm all good. So many of them. For some reason, I can sometimes get like a bunch of hits with the crowbar like that, and then sometimes it just sort of stops. Okay.
Garden dog!
So these are the headcrabs that are going to survive and evolve, because they look just like the cranes. Alright. There's a ladder. Presumably I don't just jump down. Ridiculous. Okay, so this time I will not stand in a place where the elevator comes to kill me. Takes its sweet time. Okay then. Trying to get to the... I really need to save after this fight. It's not that it's a hard fight, it's just a tedious one. Oh, maybe it isn't. Okay. So it's fairly certain with the ladder I was supposed to jump there, but the angle is not a great one. Now, are you referring to... I think there's a remake of Prey. Like, I know there was an... I think there was one that was by, like, Human Head Studios, and then there's, like, a modern remake, which I think was done by Bethesda.
Freeman, who would have thought you'd still be alive? I hope no one expects me to start up the generator. Smithers went down there and never came back.
All right, well, I'm already obsessed with saving, so...
You're still saving.
Oh, well. Ow.
Major fracture detected.
So the game doesn't want me standing still. This year's Prey was developed by Arkane Studios, published by Bethesda. That's the one you're referring to. Okay, cool. I sometimes know things about the video games.
This is my hiding spot, and I'm not moving until the situation is drastically improved. Now go away, and don't tell anyone I'm here.
Sure thing, Smithers. Oh, god damn it! Alright. You know what? I like my health. Makes sense. I'm not supposed to go in there, am I? You okay up there, Smithers? I hope I don't need to do anything else. Oh, god damn it. There we go. I never knew you could go up on this pipe.
Excellent! Someone has restored all power. We'll have the engine up again in no time.
So many ladders. Ow.
Major fracture detected.
That's rather unkind of them, rather. Tricky. Well, clearly these metal crates won't conduct electricity, right? Not smart. Screw it. I have health. We're gonna be able to kill the beastie. Thank you. Oh boy! I'll try and give you guys an example. So if I like, okay, so apparently I could jump there. Oh no, it's searching for me now. But yeah, so basically if you run or you jump, it's gonna detect you. I can't really afford to just drop anymore, so there we go. Barney. Apparently those wooden crates really made it, though. Clearly Valve is the design studio to beat on level design. Cool new gun. Alien bits. What more could you want? So I was thinking possibly of wrapping it up around here. I'm a couple minutes beyond what I wanted. But... I'd be willing... Oh no! I was gonna say, I would be mildly tempted to say I'll do maybe another 45 minutes if a donation comes in, let's say between now and when I get to the next logical saving spot. Obviously, I think almost everyone here has donated already, so clearly this is not an expectation for you to do any more than you already have. But I'm at the end of my casting thing. I probably would have stopped at the tentacle monster here, but I also wanted to try and say, it's like, okay, let's get another chance to extend it. So if there's any donation, let's say $5 or more, that comes to the Eyes of Sin, between now and sort of my next saving spot, I'll add another 45 minutes to the cast. Otherwise, I think this will be a chance to wrap it up here, and we can save it for tomorrow's cast. Yeah, that's totally fine, Joshaman. You've definitely been very, very generous this cast, and I appreciate it. The idea here is never to try and condemn people who've already donated. I try to vary the rewards as much as I can. I remember this is a bit of a pain to get through. I try to vary the rewards as much as I can to make it sort of worthwhile for people to, to keep participating. But again, the purpose behind this, if you guys just want to hang out and watch the games for the next 2 weeks, that's totally fine. I do have, for those of you who are new here, there is one motive behind why we're doing this. The last 2 days were absolutely fantastic for donations, so I wanted to make sure that we tried to keep as much of the momentum as we can. And whenever we get a chance, we you know, we I try and promote it whenever we can, either so somebody who hasn't donated gets a chance to get something nice, or you know, if nothing else, we can yeah, that's what we wanted to do. Or if nothing else, just basically to give a little bit of a reminder in terms of why things are going on like that. Like I said, if you can't, or if you already have donated, there is no expectation that you go beyond anything that's within your comfort zone, because you guys really did impress me over the first 2 days, and it's made it a little bit hard to do the next 2 weeks, just because... Man, what is it with this game and giving you, like... death everywhere? I guess you're supposed to land on the table? Oh, hello, Claymore Mine. Gravity, Joshy man. I'm always reluctant to break these kinds of crates, because they're normally ones that you solve puzzles with. It's not always the right way to look at it. Okay. I felt like that would be a good place to save, but... yep, power up. Oh, this is a great fight, too. Alright. So... next time I do Half-Life, we'll have a fun thing to start off with. Eyes of Sin, can I just confirm from you that we don't have any more donations? I didn't see any come through, but that doesn't mean that it, it wasn't listed. Assuming you're still in here, Eyes of Sin. I could be totally wrong. I think Jess is in bed too, so. If I get confirmation otherwise that a donation was given, you know, please speak up, let me know. But I'm going to guess that that's it for tonight. Thank you again, everybody. I don't have a list of tonight's donations, unfortunately. I normally kind of get that at the end, but I think we've got a couple of great people to host tonight. So let's just take a quick look at what's going on. Mm-hmm. Well, guys, that's it for me. Thank you again. This thing has worked out better than I possibly could have expected. I had a lot of fun playing Half-Life. I should maybe leave it at this. After the 2 weeks are up, would anybody here like to see me do more Half-Life, or would you prefer to see one of the other games? While you guys are answering that, I'll lead up with the next cast. Johnny Big Time is currently streaming Fortnite. He's on his new hours because he's got a new job. As I was saying a little bit earlier, Johnny Big Time is the kind of caster who I really want... I really want to see him, like, I always kind of want to get a little bit of validation from him. He always does such a good job with his casts, and he's a really entertaining broadcaster. I think he he's one of my favorite shows on Twitch for sure. He just knocks it out of the park every time. He's been playing a lot of Fortnite recently, so if you guys don't like Battle Royale games, I'd still encourage you to watch Johnny, because I think he's a uniquely talented caster and he can make anything fun. But if Fortnite isn't your thing, I completely understand. You know, you can watch him do something else. I do encourage you to follow him. And as usual, we do Raid Johnny Big Time. We're tired of System Talk, heard this place is better. We'll try the raid message as usual. So this is going to be one of those official Twitch raids, so just hit that join button if you'd like to come along on the raid. Again, everybody, thank you for your generosity with the Eyes of Sin cause. Thank you very much for spreading the word. Thank you for the feedback that I've gotten on the blog. And more importantly, thank you for supporting the cast. I mean, if we don't move up on the list of, you know, of games that are being played, like when we did Grand Theft Auto 5, obviously nobody was going to watch that who wasn't, you know, wasn't already aware of the cast. So the fact that you guys show up, the fact that you guys are fun to talk with and chat definitely makes it easier for me to do these sorts of things. And again, it's for a cause that, you know, I was hoping would turn out, but I wasn't sure about it. So you guys, again, have gone above and beyond. Thank you so much for that. Let's show Johnny the same warmth and care that you guys have given me.